Hey everyone, this is Rocky. I'm here with my friends from favediets.com, and today we're going to be making one of my favorite go-to meals, tuna melts. Let's get started. Right now I'm just chopping up some green onions. I get asked quite a bit from my grocery hauls when I mention my tuna melts, how I make them. I don't really have a set recipe. I just make them depending on what I have on hand. And what I have on hand right now are some green onions. I just added 2 cans of tuna to my bowl, and I'm just using Albacore tuna. It's the Albacore tuna in water. I switch this next part up quite a bit, just depending again on what I have on hand. Today I'm going to be using a Vidalia Onion Mustard. Sometimes I use light mayo, sometimes I use Greek yogurt. Today I'm going to use Vidalia Onion Mustard. If you don't have this and you want to try something similar, you can go ahead and use honey mustard. I'm going to add a little bit of celery salt. Just a couple of dashes. And then mix this together. I might add another tablespoon of the mustard depending. This comes together. I'm going to add one more tablespoon of the Vidalia onion mustard. To add a little bit of bite, I'm going to add some cracked black pepper. And that's our mix. Okay, I sprayed down a sheet with some olive oil spray, and I'm just prying apart my little sandwich thins. I'm using these sandwich thins right here. They're the 100 calorie whole wheat. Go ahead and put down my tuna mix. Okay, right now I'm just slicing up some tomato very thin. I'm gonna lay down my tomato slices onto each one. On my husband's tuna melts, I'm gonna go ahead and just put regular American cheese on. Since I'm allergic to dairy, on mine I'm going to go ahead and put down some veggie slices. And there we go, into the oven, 350 degrees until the cheese melts. Okay, here they are, ready for our taste test.
The Vidalia onion mustard adds a really nice sweetness to the tuna melt. And then you got the crunch from the green onions and also the sweetness from the thinly sliced tomatoes. This is really good. Really, really good. I swear, this is one of my favorite go-to meals during the middle of the week. So there you have it. If you guys have any questions, just go ahead and post them below. The nutritional facts, the full recipe, and pictures will be on my blog spot, which I'll post below. And until next time, enjoy. Bye.